What is up, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel if this is your first time here. My name is Hope, and today's video I'm so excited for. Once again, I am currently in the car getting ready to leave to go to Hannah's house in Michigan, and we are going and seeing Youngblood. I am driving 7 hours by myself there right now, so like, wish me luck. This is gonna be interesting. But yeah, I will update you guys along the way or just whenever I get there.
Hello!
I'm so excited!
Me too!
Yes!
Oh, I'm so excited.
We made it! And we're first. That's our chairs. Oh my god, I'm not gonna be able to stop.
Hopefully no homeless man steals them.
We already had a creepy homeless guy standing there being all fucking weird, and we had to wait to set our chairs out. We both got our hair colored and we're hiding it until we don't look like potatoes. I probably should have like said that from the start. That's okay. But yeah, we're here. We made it.
We're the first ones.
Mate, it's asking me crazy. Hello. How's it going? Yeah? I'm gonna go get a shower because I stink.
We made it.
Oh! Guess what? This moment's coming and never around you again. If you are here, you are with me. You are with us. Look at the people around you. You finally belong somewhere. These people will protect you. These people will defend you. They will love you and they will accept you. So people are fucking bones in the story. And they should fucking love.
Yeah! And this song is called Anarchist. She climbs so.
Yeah, that was pretty fucking loud. Now this song just came out with Mr. Machine Gun
Thank you.
fucking important to me. This song is so important to me because I believe that there is hope for the underrated youth. Now sing this in a trick. If I let you pay, would you wait for me or would you throw what's on the way? I'm not easy to say, to the car.
Detroit, you won one fucking lot.
I wanna see a big fat fucking mosh pit open right now. Cause this song's got a machine gun.
Made it out alive.
Barely.
Yeah, true. My throat hurts, my body hurts.
Not like the other kids.
Can you write out lyrics for a tattoo? From Hope for the Underrated Youth, your favorite lyrics. Whatever your favorite lyrics are from Hope for the Underrated Youth.
And then a little black heart.
And with a heart, please.
You do a heart.
He did. Thank you so much. So I know that you guys can like barely see me, but it's fine because whenever I get home, I'm gonna pass out and I don't want to sit there and record. And I'm driving right now and have nothing better to do. So we're gonna have a little story time about the concert last night. So starting off, we got there at 6 a.m. We were the first ones in line. Probably like an hour after we got there, these two other girls showed up and they were so nice and so sweet. We loved them, we became friends with them. As we're sitting there, this lady comes up and asks, do we have fast passes? And meanwhile, none of us knew what that was. Like, we had no idea what a fast pass was. So we asked her, and she proceeds to tell us that it's a pass that gets you to skip the line and like you get in front of everyone. So we all instantly get pretty upset because like we were there that early to be front row. Like you get there early to secure your spot for front row. And then these people can show up 10 minutes before doors and end up in front of you just because they have the money to spend on these fast passes. So we were all pretty upset. We let it go through most of, like, throughout the day and everything. And then whenever workers started showing up at the venue, I stopped one of them and asked if we were able to purchase fast passes. Because I wasn't gonna be fucking in the back whenever I drove basically 10 hours to get there. And I paid a lot of money to be there. And I'm not gonna pay all of that money to be in the back. So I was willing to spend the extra however much money it was to get these fast passes. I was talking to the worker. We ended up finding out that we were able to purchase them at 5 o'clock. So great, all right, everything's fine. We had talked to the like lady that got there, the first one in the fast pass line. We were talking to her throughout the day. She was lovely. She was wonderful. She was an older woman. She was holding her spot for her daughter and her daughter's boyfriend. And she was an angel. Like, she was so nice and so sweet. And we asked her, we were like, hey, if we are able to end up purchasing fast passes, is it okay if we get in our spot in front of you since, like, we were here before you were? And she was like, oh my gosh, yes. Like, that is absolutely no problem at all. Like, she wanted us to be in front of her because we were there since 6 a.m. So she was like, yes, absolutely, go for it. So 5 o'clock rolls around, we get our fast passes, we go back and get in line. There's this group of girls that get attitude about it. And we were trying to explain to them, like, they were like, oh, well, we paid for these. And I was like, yeah, so did we. Like, all of us paid the same amount for these tickets. It doesn't matter if you had them before us or not. We still paid for them as well. And also, we got here at 6 a.m. And eventually, they were just like, okay, whatever about us. Like, they didn't care about us being in front of them anymore. So they were like, whatever. And that's what the girl told us, at least. She was like, oh, okay, like, that's fine. You guys are fine. And then another group comes back, and it's probably like a group of like 8 of them, and they try getting in their spot that they were in the general admission line. Like, we were all numbered, so they tried getting into their spot too, which this set off a fucking war between everyone, which I understand though, because like having 8 people get in front of you instead of 4, that's insane. Like, that is a lot. So I kind of understand where they were coming from on that one. But the one girl who started problems, like, whenever we originally walked back, and then told us it was fine and whatever, goes and gets someone that works at the venue and bitches to them about all of us. So then that bigger group just went to the back of the fast pass line. They said, like, fuck it, and went to the back of the fast pass line. And then we thought we were fine because she had told us that we were fine. She had told us that she didn't care that we were up there because we were there since 6 a.m. She was like, oh yeah, you guys deserve it, whatever. But proceeds to get the security guard to come over to us. And the security guard was like, okay, I just want to get both sides of the story right now. I heard her side, what's going on. And I like went off. I was like, we have been here since 6 a.m. I drove a total of 10 hours. I came the whole way from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I had talked to this woman earlier to make sure that she was okay with us getting in front of her, which she was. She had no problem with it. She was there to back me up about it. She did not care. And then this girl, again, comes forward and is like, well, you didn't talk to us about it. And I'm like, you just told us that it was fine, but all right. And then the security guard grabs me, Hannah, and the two girls that we made friends with and is like, come with me. So all of us instantly start literally panicking. I almost go into a panic attack. Hannah does go into a panic attack because he's not telling us what's going on. He just took us out of the fast pass line and took us to the front of the venue and like didn't tell us anything as to what was going on. So Hannah literally goes into a full-blown panic attack and is standing there bawling her eyes out because like we paid a lot of money to be there, and then we paid an extra $20 that neither of us really had for these fast passes. So we were like, if we paid for these and we don't even get to use them, then like that's $20 down the drain, and $20 is a lot of fucking money. So like, what are we gonna do? So all of us are panicking, and then this one fucking angel security guard comes over to us and starts asking us if we're okay, what's going on. Like, he was genuinely concerned, and I appreciated it so much. It was just asking if we were okay, and then he explained to us, he was like, listen, you guys are getting in before the fast pass line. All of us know that you guys have been here since 6 a.m. and you're not just bullshitting. You guys are getting in before the fast pass line. So we all finally calmed down. We're all still like shaken up and everything. And because those girls were starting problems, the security guards were concerned for us. And they were like, if at any point during the show, these girls try to do something, try to say something, you hold up your phone and you flash your flashlight at us like a signal to like coming down and help you guys. Best security at any event I have ever been to. Any other event I've been to, the security guards would not have given a shit and would have just basically put us at the back of the line. Like, they were fucking angels the whole entire time. And the one photographer there, he was taking pictures of us all morning. He knew we were there all day as well. And he came out and saw us standing there crying and walks up to us and was like, are you guys okay? Like, everyone at this venue, all of the staff, were absolutely fucking amazing. I've been to, I think, over 100 shows at this point, and I have never had security guards as nice as them. It literally, they, like, made the event for us. Like, it was amazing. And then we get inside, we get fucking barricade. I was so excited. And as we're standing there, we see the group of girls that were bitching at us walk in and just give us the nastiest fucking looks. I was like, hey, you earn your spot at shows. This fast pass bullshit, no, fuck that. Just because you have money doesn't mean that you get the privilege of being front row. You earn that shit. That's how concerts work, is you earn your spot. That's why I get there at fucking 6 a.m. for this. That's why I do road trips and like all of this shit. No, earn your spot and be fucking respectful of the people that are there that early to earn their fucking spot. It was, oh my god, it was great watching the reactions whenever they were walking in. Like, they were so pissed off, but oh well. That's how concerts work. We ended up paying for the fast passes too, so it doesn't even matter. Like, we all paid the same price to be there. And then, like, the show starts. Openers were great. Like, they were a great band. It was so much fun. And then YUNGBLUD comes out, and holy fucking shit, this crowd was absolutely insane. Like, probably one of the most crazy crowds that I've experienced so far. I wouldn't say the craziest or the worst, but like, it was up there. and Hannah isn't really used to this. So Hannah is really, really tiny and starts getting crushed. So she starts having another panic attack. And this is like during one of the songs that all of this is happening. I don't even remember. I'm still like really out of it, but during one of the songs this is happening and she's having a panic attack, and Dom just looks over at her and blows her a kiss. It was the sweetest fucking thing ever. It was so cute. And then she started crying even harder, but it was like happy tears because he blew her a kiss, and like that was really sweet of him and cute. So she starts crying even harder, and then eventually she was able to calm down. I was like helping her like breathe, like I was holding her hand. I was doing the best that I could in that situation to try to help her. All meanwhile, people are being pulled out of the crowd constantly for passing out. People are crowd surfing and crushing people because they're crowd surfing. It was fucking insane. At one point, me and Hannah almost got split up. Like these two girls like shoved their way in between us. I never grabbed onto anyone so hard in my life because like I knew how she was feeling. Like she was still panicking a little bit. I latched onto Hannah. I was not letting go. And then the one security guard who had been helping us the whole entire night like stepped in and told those girls to back up so Hannah could be next to me. Like, oh my god, I just can't get over how amazing the security was. And that one photographer guy, like in between the opener and Youngblood set, he comes over and looks at me and Hannah and goes, these two, they've been here all day. And like we started joking around with him, like they were great, so amazing. And at one point Adam was like doing his little solo thing, and like me and Hannah are like going along with it, like dancing with it, and everyone else is just standing there, and we're making the security guards laugh and everything. It was amazing. It was so much fun. And then every single time I see him live, every time he sings Polygraph Eyes, I just fucking sob uncontrollably. Like it fucking hurts my heart, and I'm standing there bawling my eyes out and screaming the song at the top of my fucking lungs. And then for the first time ever during that song, Dom looks at me and like sings to me for a second, and I broke down. I'm literally tearing up thinking about it. Like I just fucking broke down. That broke me, because like that song means a lot to me and everything. So yeah, I was a fucking mess. And then I finally got to hear Hope for the Underrated Youth live, and holy shit, I didn't think I was gonna, I knew I was gonna cry, but I didn't think I was gonna cry as hard as I did. I literally was like full on ugly sobbing, like to that point where you could like barely breathe kind of sobbing. I was just an absolute disaster, but it was so amazing. And that song also means so, so much to me. And it pulled me out of a really dark place. And like, yeah, it just, that song means a lot to me. And yeah, so that was basically like the whole concert experience itself. And also like literally within the first song, I was screaming so loud that like I completely dried out my throat. And no matter how much water I drank, I couldn't get it to like not be all like scratchy. So I started coughing so hard that I was like gagging because I was coughing so hard. It eventually like went away for the most part, but like even now it's still every once in a while it just feels like I'm being like stabbed in the throat. But that was it for like the concert itself. He always puts on a fucking amazing show. His energy will always be unmatched. Like it's absolutely insane. Then after the show, we obviously went to the back for the signing, and they set up the dumpster for him to stand on, and he came out, got on top of the dumpster, and then all of us fucking mobbed the dumpster. It was horrifying. And then I got him, oh god, I'm gonna get emotional. I got him to write out the tattoo that I wanted. I wanted lyrics from Hope for the Underrated Youth. I didn't know which ones I wanted, so I told him to write out his favorite ones, and he wrote out, "That'll make it better." Oh god, I'm all teary-eyed now. So, I'm eventually going to get that tattooed. Yeah, right after I read what he wrote, I instantly started just fucking sobbing uncontrollably. Like, again, I don't think I've ever cried so much at a show. But it was happy tears, so like, it's okay. I just started bawling my fucking eyes out. And like, I was shaking so bad. And then we go to the front of the venue because we were gonna stand there and see if he came out afterwards so then Hannah could hug him, because I got to see him before the show. I hugged him before the show and got to show him my jacket and everything, and it was fucking amazing. And then we go to the front, we see Adam standing there, so I talked to Adam for a minute, and I like walked up to him with the picture of my jacket that he had reposted on his Instagram story, and I was like, you reposted this on your Instagram story a while ago, and I just wanted to say thank you, like that fucking made my day, like that was awesome. He was like, oh yeah, that was so fucking sick. And then I showed him and I was like, and I made this jacket that I'm wearing now too. And he loved it. He thought it was so cool. I got to show him my shirt too. And then he talked about how he likes to like customize some clothes too. Like he bleached his pants and stuff like that. Like he was so sweet. And then I finally got a good picture with him for once. But anyway, so moving on. We're standing there. And like there's a little group of us standing out front at this point. And this car is driving by, and then we hear a pop, and none of us really knew what it was. And then we look behind us, and there is a car on fire behind us. And it's right next to the tour bus, like literally, like probably maybe 2 feet away from the tour bus. And Tom was on there. Tom hopped off the bus so fast. And then they had to move the tour bus to the other side of the venue. And this dude's car was literally on fire. And then he opens the hood, which you aren't supposed to do apparently, so that everyone is screaming at him to close it. And then they finally get fire extinguishers. And it was interesting. It was very, very interesting. Like, what? All of us were just like, what the fuck just happened? This dude's car just literally fucking caught on fire out of nowhere. But after that, we kind of moved to the back of the venue because none of us wanted to be near that. Even though the fire was put out, still there's always the chance of it reigniting. So we didn't want to be around that. So we all moved to the back of the venue and everything. And then we were gonna wait and see if Dog came out. And then we said bye to our friends, and then we like walked towards the tour bus to see if he's there by any chance, and we literally just missed him, like watched him get onto the fucking tour bus, because of course that's our luck. So unfortunately Hannah didn't get to officially meet him and everything, but there's always another chance to do so. So like it's not that big of a deal. I just wish she had been able to get a hug and get some pictures and stuff too. But overall, I had a great fucking time. I made some great friends. He put on an amazing show as usual. Are we surprised? Nope, not at all. I got my tattoo. I got to show him my jacket. I could not have asked for a better experience other than the bullshit that happened with the girls, but still it worked out in our favor in the end. So yeah, that's basically it. I'm on my way home. I still have 4 hours and 49 minutes left of this drive, so I'm probably just gonna go home and pass out. I might stop and get some Taco Bell first because I'm starving, and then just go home and pass the fuck out and sleep all day tomorrow too. So yeah, that's it. That was a lot, but if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to like, subscribe, and comment, and turn on my post notifications so you never miss a post. Follow me on all of my social media in the description. Go follow my customized clothing Instagram. You can order yourself a Youngblood jacket if you would like one. I will happily make a ton of Youngblood jackets. So please go do that. Go follow that Instagram. It's down in the description. But yeah, that is it for this video. I love you guys so, so, so much. Thank you for watching this. Yeah, that is all. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.